Good morning and welcome to St Andrew's Online on Sunday the 9th of August. Each Sunday throughout the summer we're gathering to pray and to explore the biblical story of Ruth. It's a little book within the Old Testament and it's only 4 chapters long. Why not find a time to read the story through this week? Now as we begin, together though apart, I invite you to say these words. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. We take a few moments now to be still, to remember that God is with us, and that God loves us with an unfailing love. Today, as we join together in worship, we will continue to retell the short story of Ruth and learn from the characters within it. We've already heard of Naomi and Orpah, and today we focus in on Ruth. With them in mind, let's give thanks for God's unfailing love, joining in with the response. We thank you for your unfailing love. When we feel empty, broken, or ashamed like Naomi, together we thank you for your unfailing love. When we face difficult decisions and feel torn like Orpah, we thank you for your unfailing love. When we feel conspicuous, vulnerable, or brave like Ruth, we thank you for your unfailing love. When we experience the generosity and protection of people like Boaz, we thank you for your unfailing love. When we witness love, commitment, and new life like the people of Bethlehem, we thank you for your unfailing love. And when we realize that you have written us into your story of salvation, we thank you, Lord, for your unfailing love. Amen. We take a few moments now to reflect on our lives in the light of God's love, to acknowledge our brokenness, to confess our sins, and to seek God's forgiving love and renewing power. I invite you now to join with me in this prayer of confession. Lord, our God, in our sin we have sometimes avoided your call. Our love for you can be like a morning cloud, like the dew that goes away early. Have mercy on us and deliver us. Bind up our wounds and revive us. Amen. May the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. During this next song, let's rejoice in God's forgiving love and God's renewing power.
Stories of why they think you're like, and I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I never alone. You're a good, good farmer. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to
think as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still into love, love, love. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am.
We now turn to our reflection on the Bible, looking at Ruth chapter 2 through the eyes of the character of Ruth. And we invite Emma Howarth from St. Helen's Parish Church to share with us today.
Exploring the Book of Ruth, part 3. This is part of a series of reflections exploring the short story of Ruth from the Old Testament. Today we focus on Ruth chapter 2, Finding Food and Favour. Well, it seems that life is not really turning out the way I expected it to. I thought that by now I would have at least 3 or 4 children and a happy home with my husband. It is a long way from how I imagined life to be. Poor Naomi. She has nothing left. No husband to care for her. No sons to carry on her name. When she told me to stay with my family, I just couldn't. I loved my husband very much, and I couldn't bear to leave his mother with nothing. She is my mother. I am her daughter. Her pain is my pain, and her home will be my home. Poor Naomi. She is returning to the land of her family. We have heard that there the harvest is plentiful, and maybe this will bring peace to Naomi. Maybe she will find happiness in the place of her family. It pains me to leave my mother and father, but I have many brothers and sisters who will care for them, and Naomi only has me now. Today I went to the fields to glean what I could so that we may eat. Naomi cannot work. She is too old and tired. I am young and hard work does not scare me. I know that here the harvest workers are kind, for Naomi told me that the people of Israel will leave fallen grains for the poor and the foreigners. I like this tradition. Apparently, their God told them to do this, to show kindness to the stranger. I asked Naomi why they would do this, and she told me it was so that they wouldn't forget how God was good to them when they were in exile as strangers in a foreign land. Anyway, whatever the reason, this is what I went to do. It's been a long, hot day. The workers in the field were very kind to me. They let me pick up the bits that they had dropped. I was a bit fearful when the owner of the fields turned up, though. I thought he might have turned me away. He was very gracious and kind and gave me some food. More food than I could eat as it happened. He told me to carry on picking in his fields and to take water if I needed it. He told his men not to bother me, and for that I am very grateful. It is hard enough work without fending off unwanted attention. I asked him why he would do this for me, and he told me it was because I have come to the Lord God of Israel for protection. Funny answer. I didn't really think of it that way. I had just followed Naomi, and I am willing to accept her ways and traditions. I suppose by coming back to her land, to her people, I am coming to them for protection. I suppose that by doing that, then I am turning to their God for protection. Not so bad then. Anyway, the afternoon was long, but I seemed to pick up a lot of grain. At the end of the day, after I had threshed it, I was rather astonished to find I had an ephah, which is about 30 pounds in your measures. Naomi was over the moon when I came back. She couldn't believe the quantity of grain I had. It would feed us for a fortnight. Naomi asked who owned the field I had been working in, and I told her the owner was called Boaz. Well, she carried on as if I told her it was royalty. She explained that Boaz was a close relative of her dead husband, and she was sure that the Lord God had sent us to that place so that Boaz would look after us. I slipped in the information about Boaz telling me to keep gathering grain with his workers until they finished the harvest, and Naomi was so pleased. She told me I should do this because it was much safer this way. I am pleased that this has lifted Naomi's spirits. She was so despondent. She seems to have much more hope for the future now. And as for me, I can see how kind Boaz has been to me. He really doesn't seem to want anything from me or have an ulterior motive. I feel safe and protected, and I liked it when he told me I was under the wings of his God, That is a secure feeling, and goodness knows I haven't felt secure for a long time. When I reflected on the way that Boaz treated me and the way that Naomi received his help, it made me think that their God has a big heart. One of the workers told me about the grace of their God. When I asked her what she meant, she said that grace is when God shows favour to his people without them earning it or deserving it. And I guess that is what Boaz showed towards me. Are we mindful of those on the edges who may feel excluded or exposed? Do we reflect God's grace when we deal with others? Where do we find our security?
We now turn to prayer. And as the music plays, I invite you to bring your prayers to God, whether prayers of thanks and praise, prayers of sadness and confusion, or prayers of need and longing. God welcomes them all. Quiet or spoken, or written in the comments.
Thank you.
we draw our prayers together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory, the King above all. The power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory, the King above all. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing. That you've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. worthy, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Amazing grace, this is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for that you've done for me.
As we draw to a close, I invite you to join with me in this prayer. In darkness and in light, in trouble and in joy, help us, Heavenly Father, to trust in your love, to serve your purpose, and to praise your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen. As we go, we recall these well-known words from the first chapter of Ruth, where she says, "Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God." So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. Our next St. Andrew's Online will be on Facebook on Wednesday evening. In the meantime, you can find more information about St. Andrew's on our website, www.standrewsdentonsgreen.org.